sweet home, sweet home. I met a man who lives in Tennessee.
Well, hello, families. So glad you're with us, boys and girls. Today is another day in which we get to talk about Advent. And today is actually the 11th day that we're celebrating Advent. And I bet you're as curious as I am what's behind door number 11 in our Advent calendar. What do you say we take a look? What do we have here? Well, this looks to me like angel wings. Do you know the Christmas story is filled with angels making appearances? Why, an angel appeared to Mary, and an angel appeared to Joseph, and a host of angels appeared to the shepherds in the fields. Angels were really busy. Speaking of angels, that reminds me of a good friend that I have. He knows a lot about angels, and I hope he appears to us today on our show. Well,
Greg,
hello, Ed.
How are you?
Well, this is Pastor Ed.
How are you?
Good to have you here.
Thank you very much.
You know, I was just telling the boys and girls that you're an expert on angels. You know a lot about angels.
I know some things, sure.
Well, maybe you could share some things with us.
Well, angels are basically messengers of God. God tells angels what to say, and they go and deliver the messages. Most of the time, angels are big and powerful and bright. And most of the time, they do some sort of service for their human counterpart.
Well, they were pretty busy at Christmas time, weren't they?
Very busy. They were appearing all over the place, giving all sorts of messages about the coming king.
Well, thanks for telling us about angels, Ed.
You bet.
You know, I've got some friends in the land of imagination, and I bet they'd love for you to visit with them.
All right. I'll go right over.
Maggie! Remember we've been learning all about angels? I want to be an angel one day, too. What kind of angel do you want to be?
Oh, Max, I think I'm going to be an angel with a bright yellow halo.
I can see that, yeah.
Yeah, and maybe some big glittery wings.
Well, I want huge wings, too, but also a flaming sword!
Whoa! That's kind of scary.
Yeah, it's strong, and I'm going to fly. Do you want to fly, too?
Yeah. Oh, I would love to fly.
Yeah, I think that's what angels get to do. Wow! Ed! Hi!
Hi, what are you guys talking about?
We're talking about how we're going to be angels one day.
You're all going to be angels one day.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Like you personally.
Yeah, we're going to turn into angels when we die.
Well, see, that's not exactly the way it goes. Angels were created by God a long time ago to be messengers to people, to serve them. You get to come to heaven if you believe in Jesus and put your personal trust in Him. But that's not really the way it works with angels and the fact that you don't get to become them. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Oh, good.
What? Where'd he go?
I don't know. Is he an angel?
Maybe.
Whoa.
Thanks so much for joining us today on the Family Christmas Show. We learned a lot about angels. And I sure hope you'll come back tomorrow because you never know who's going to show up at our door or what fun we're going to have in the land of imagination. And be sure to join us at Bay Area Community Church on Christmas Eve as we celebrate the incredible birth of our Savior. See you tomorrow.
I met a man who lives in Tennessee, and he was heading for Pennsylvania and some homemade pumpkin pie. From Pennsylvania, folks are traveling down to Dixie's sunny shore. From Atlantic to Pacific,
gee, the traffic is terrific. Oh, there's no...